Actually, I'm gonna fuck off.
Hmm. Well, alright then. Whatever you say.
He's looking down at his desk like I just reprimanded him. He must really want some company. Well, too bad. Well, I know Chester said he was going to find Dozer to head to the gym if Dozer didn't have a class. Darius is normally skulking around there too, but for other reasons. As for Spencer, I'm not really sure where he'd be. He turned in his paper and left without saying much. Oh, thanks for that. I'll see who I can find. I'll catch you later, coach.
See you tomorrow.
Where should I go?
Let's go to the library.
Library's always a good place to go. I could go for some place. Oh, shit. I skipped that. It'll give me a good chance to look over my math homework and brush up on the current topic. There doesn't seem to be anyone in the library right now. It's unusually quiet.
Whoa! Whoa! Holy shit! What is this? Jesus fucking Christ, did I walk into the fucking Twilight Zone? Jesus! You know you shouldn't be loud in the library.
I'm sorry, you fucking scared me! I've never seen him in the library before. How did someone so big sneak up on me?
Who are you?
I've never seen you in the library before. Are you new here?
I'm currently covering for the other librarian while she's away. If you need anything, you can just call me Waffle.
What?
What?
Waffle?
Waffle? Is that an issue?
Oh, no, it's not. Just a unique nickname?
Are you alone?
Is there anyone else in the library other than you?
There's one other person in the back, some husky who came in to study. Name's Spencer, I do believe is what he said.
Nothing. Why do they all have such ginormous bulges? Like Jesus Christ. You walk around like that?
Well, welcome to campus.
I came here to study myself since it's the quietest place around.
I'll leave you to your studies then. If you need any assistance finding a book, let me know.
Thanks. I'll be off now.
Goodbye.
That guy was pretty huge. I certainly don't want to be on his bad side. Now let me find a good spot to study. I always like sitting near the windows here. It's warm and one of the more secluded spots here. And it looks like I found someone else in the same spot I like to sit.
Hey, David.
Sup, Spence. Didn't expect to find you back here.
Best spot to study. Normally pretty quiet here and almost nobody comes back this way.
Right. That's why I like it back here. Mind if I join you? I'm gonna look over my math homework.
Sure, I don't mind. We just have to keep it down so, Waffle doesn't come back here.
Intimidating guy, isn't he?
On first glance, yeah. We talked a bit and he's interesting enough. Says he's doing research here while filling in for Mrs. Swartz. He didn't mention what kind, though, but I guess that's none of our business.
Yeah. What are you here studying for today?
I was actually here doing the homework for math myself. I wasn't able to get it done last night.
Really? Really? That's unlike you. You always get your work done on time.
Yeah, you know me. I had other things to do yesterday, though, and didn't have the time to finish. Don't expect it to happen anymore, though.
Still, it's surprising that you didn't finish it. What was so important that you didn't set aside time to do homework? I mean, you're always on top of it.
Nothing to be concerned about.
Oh, okay. He's hiding something from me. I've known Spencer for a long time and I can tell when he's keeping something. His tail is thrashing around behind him. He really wants to avoid this conversation.
Leave it be for now, I guess.
I'm not going to pry into it. When he says not to be concerned about something, I should listen. One time he told me to stop asking him about something, and all he did was give me the cold shoulder eventually. Lasted for days. He broods on his anger and has a sharp tongue when he's mad. He tends to try to stay quiet.
Well, if you ever feel like talking about it, you can talk to me, you know.
I appreciate that.
I should leave him alone while he's finishing his homework. If I irritate him too much, he'll make me pay for it on the courts. He might not look angry, but he plays aggressively and is relentless with his racket. I've seen how he plays with Chester when he's irritated.
and I don't want to be on the receiving end of that. Time to focus on reviewing my work to make sure I did everything correctly.
Excuse me, you two.
Yes, what is it, Waffle?
I overheard you two saying you were doing work for your math class today, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
I'll go ahead and inform you that that class was canceled for today, as the teacher is feeling under the weather.
Really? Okay then, I guess I don't have to worry too much about this for now. Thanks for letting us know.
You're welcome. Now I'll leave you two to your studies.
Despite what he just heard, Spencer is still working away. I'd not expect him to stop anyway. Perhaps I should do the same. If I finish checking my work now, I won't have to deal with it later. Talk to Spencer. I guess since we don't have class, there's no reason to stick around here. Why is that? Isn't it smarter to just go ahead and finish while I have the time free?
I suppose that's true. You shouldn't jump at every chance you get to slack off. Now finish looking over your work.
Okay, what are you, my fucking dad? My fucking mom?
That's something I'd expect to hear from a teacher. But he's right. I'll keep looking over my work till he's done. I'm done with my work, so Spencer should be finished soon. I'm getting kinda bored just sitting here staring at the problems I know are correct. Looking out the window, the world seems so inviting right now. Maybe I should have gone out there to do my homework?
You look bored, David.
Well, I'm done checking over my work. I've double-checked everything now.
That's good. You should get a good grade on this assignment, then.
I just finished checking my work, too, so I'm pretty much done for the day when it comes to school.
Did you have anything planned for after class?
I normally grab some lunch after math.
Oh, shit, I skipped. Fucking... God damn it.
No, I don't normally eat there. Just a block over. There's a cafe I like to go to. They have some of the best burgers around.
You're welcome to join me if you'd like to.
Sure, I can afford to have a decent lunch today, so I'm down to go with you.
Cool, let's head off then.
Here we are. This place has great food and a pretty calm atmosphere to it. I like to come here and just order a drink and study.
Looks like a nice place. You said you like the hamburgers here, right?
Yeah, that's what I suggest you try. I'm sure you'll like it too.
I'll trust you on that. Let's order and grab a seat then.
I really like how chill it is out here. Not too many people around and it's away from the busy street. Not to mention, this weather's perfect. I never knew this place existed and it's so close to the school.
It's kind of hidden away though, so it's not a surprise. A lot of people have never seen it before.
I try to spread the word when I can so they get more traffic. It's picked up a lot in the past several months.
Hey, Spencer, here's your orders.
Thanks, Hal. David, this is Hal. He's one of the owners of this place.
Pleasure to meet you. Spence here's a regular with us. See him a few times a week at least. Feels like he's what keeps us in business.
Haha, I don't come by often enough to do that.
You guys enjoy your food, and if you need anything, just holler, alright?
Will do, Hal. Thanks.
Nice guy, seems pretty cool.
He's a great guy, really friendly, and that's what brings back a lot of people. Though, I'm a little concerned about them.
Why is that?
I was chatting with him recently, and he said despite business picking up, they're barely making enough money to stay afloat. I've offered to volunteer here with my free time, but they are too proud to take handouts or the like. I'd hate to see this place just vanish. I wish there was something more we could do than just tell people about it.
Maybe there is something more we can do for them.
You have something in mind?
A fundraiser, events, yes, events.
Maybe we can host an event or something here. The tennis team has had a lot of support at the college, so an event hosted here would bring a lot of people and spread word about them.
That's not a bad idea.
It supports us and the cafe without it looking suspicious.
Good thinking, David. Next thing, we just have to decide what kind of event we'd want to have.
Any idea there?
A music event, a pre-season celebration, a car wash, what? No.
Pre-season celebration.
Music events seem to bring in decent crowds. Maybe we can have a band or something play?
It can be sort of a pre-season celebration for the team.
You're onto something there.
It could bring in a decent enough crowd and really get the word out of this place. I'll talk to Hal about it and see what he thinks about letting us host something here. I'm glad you decided to come out with me today. Those are some great ideas and I think it can really help this place out. The food is really good, so we have to get the word out that this place exists. Heh. Glad you feel that way about it. Since I'm done eating, I'm going to head in and talk to Hal about all this if you don't mind. I'll talk to you sometime tomorrow and let you know what the plan is, alright? Okay, sounds good to me. See you later, David. Later, Spence. I suppose I'm going to head back to the shelter now, since there's nothing else for me to do around here. Looks like Maria and Richard are outside doing some landscaping. They've gotten a lot done since I left for school this morning. Welcome home, David. What do you think of the new gardens we've added here?
It looks nice. It looks pretty good. It looks pretty good. It makes a great addition to the shelter.
Doesn't it? I'm sure it'll lift the spirits of people here, and it'll give them something else to do. Gardening does wonders for stress, doesn't it, Richard?
If you think so. It causes more stress if you ask me.
Oh, come on now, don't say that. Just wait until everything blooms. It'll look so lovely.
And think of what that'll do to my allergies. I'm going to be a teary-eyed, stuffy-nosed mess.
Goodness, Richard, you'll be fine. You'll see.
Richard always seems irritated or angry, but I know how much he cares about the shelter and Maria. He's always trying to help her and keep the place in order. Well, I can't wait to see everything in bloom. I'm sure it's going to look beautiful.
Well, David, you're always free to add plants to it or change it up if you like. I'd like everyone to help with it to give it a unique look, but I know not everyone likes these kinds of things. I might add my own touch to it at some point. Wonderful! Feel free to add whatever kinds of plants you like.
Okay, Maria. I'm going to head to my room now, so if you need anything, let me know. And back into the storyboard room we go. Back in my room, I guess I'm just going to take a nap and burn some time till dinner. I have no other plans for the rest of the day. I think I'll just stay in tonight and relax. What's going on?
Spencer?
I'd never expect to see him in his underwear. What a silly situation. He's always so reserved about this kind of thing.
Well, that was an oddly satisfying dream. I'd never expect to see him like that. Even in the years I've known him, I've only ever seen him without his shirt on maybe once. Wondering just how he looks like without his clothes on is enticing. To the point of making me rock hard right now.
Oh!
Well, I can't say this is the first time he's ever had this effect on me, and there's only one thing to do now. A quick jerk should quell this feeling for now.
Spence, you. Just about there. Whoa.
I tend to dream about him more and more often lately. And every time I wake up, it's the same thing, but it always feels so damn good. He's probably my closest friend, but I don't know what he'd do if I ever told him how I feel. It's something I've had to deal with for some time now, and I guess it's something I'm going to have to continue to hide. I had better get cleaned up before holding out for the day. Time to take a quick shower.
And with that, that's where I'm going to leave off this first session of Extracurricular Activities. It's pretty interesting so far. I like the concept. It looks promising to say the least. So, if you guys liked this video and you would like to see a video similar to this one, leave a like, comment, and if you like what you see, please do subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at Kawaii Raccoonie and watch me on Fur Affinity also at Kawaii Raccoonie. Links to both of those things in the description down below. My name is Lovely Parasite, and I am out of here.